Briefcase with $1 million even. This all week, no days off. This hard work gon' pay y'all. I made myself a promise young. I would never work a day job. Put it in the safe. Never know when I'm gon' need that. Came in with my gang. You don't know. I don't know why my chats are coming in Russian. I don't speak Russian, so I don't know if y'all are talking to each other, but it ain't working for me, but okay. What's up, Cuff Daddy? I mean, if there's going to be some chat bots in my shit, you could think they could at least have the chat bots in fucking English so I can at least pretend to interact with them. Let's see what we got. I'm streaming on Twitch and on YouTube right now. I have 15 viewers on Twitch. I have 0 on YouTube because YouTube fucking loves me because I am just the most entertaining ever. But their defense, this is literally my first time on YouTube. So, but shout out Restream for having the ability to stream multiple platforms at once. As soon as Facebook lets me, I'm not sure why they won't, I'll be on Facebook too. Hey Cuffy, how was your Thanksgiving, my guy? Right, 6 yards is better than 1,000. Sit down. That RPO wasn't hitting, was it? Ooh, you ate plenty. Bet. This is the first year since my weight loss surgery that I didn't overeat and I didn't get sick. I mean, I felt like trash because my concussion and, I had to do too much.
my mom and dad have been having a lot of health issues, so I had to do a lot of the cooking day of, and it was just too much. But, you know, it's my mom. I'd do anything for her. So. You know, gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, is it still echoey, or did I get it fixed? Got him. See, he thought I was in man coverage. I audibled out to Tampa 2. Knowing the alignment was the same, they wouldn't shuffle. So got him. I mean, it's only 9 yards, but fuck, it's 9 yards. You know what I'm saying? Oh, no echo? Nice. Guess I know what I'm doing sometimes. Hey, I got 100 people viewing my stream on Twitch, so that's what's up. First down, okay. All right. Slam. Oof. Should have waited an extra second. But at least it was incomplete. Okay, alright. Alright, that's good for you, man. I know I've gained about 60 pounds since my initial loss, but that's just because, you know, I hurt my back, and then I hurt my back again, and then, you know, I just got my fucking head injury. But, you know. Damn it, I held the button down. He was supposed to fucking hand it off. Oh well. Let's just hit the go-to. Oh, fuck, I ran out of bounds. Son of a bitch. What the fuck was that? I'm not fucking punting the ball. Oh, you son of a bitch. All right. Oh, yeah. Give it away now. Give it away. Give it away. Give it away now. Sit down. Oh, damn, I shouldn't have did that. Sit down. Why is everybody talking in fucking Russian? Sit down. Ooh, got him. Got him. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming. Back to throw, Fields. That's a good call with the field goal. I mean, he's getting yards, but he's got a couple chunk plays and everything else, he's not getting shit. And the chunk plays were just because of that bad play call. So. Come on. That's not going to be fucking intercepted in real life. Come on. That was a bad tackle on my part. Oh, come on. Come
and run. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. This short pass,
it didn't work like I wanted it to. Come the...
Here about ready for their next drive. They have a good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket. No reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together.
God, I'm fucking self-destructing. Okay, I gotta get out of the zone. Obviously, he knows how to fucking bust the zone. I got nothing to lose. I'm gonna run this bitch out, see what we got.
Thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it and we'll see these two teams go to the offense.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation, either side of the ball. Just go ahead, finish up the half, and get on out and talk.
Nah, wait.
They've been kept off the scoreboard in this first half, but here toward the end, they're trying to change that in one fell swoop, but that winds up incomplete.
Vic with the incompletion on first down, and now that leads to second and 10. Here's Michael Vick rolling to his left. Just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds.
Evident there that he learned his lesson from the last drive. Nick Wilson is going to force a throw that time, but nothing broke open, kept it, and ended up running for a first down itself.
This will be the final play of the half. Big with the flat drop deep for Cooper. And it's not going to be complete. So two quarters down. Short of the goal line, and they'll begin this third quarter at their own 25. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find somewhere to string something together here. Don't forget,
so as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained. Maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. Throwing again, Vic on second and 10. Buying time to his left.
Calm the... I gotta go for it at this point. I don't have much of a choice.
Throw. Oh, and now Vic throwing another interception.
I ain't gonna tell this motherfucker GG's, man. That ass whooping was horrible. That was bad. I mean, I know I'm not a good Madden player. I say that all the time. I don't have any qualms about it. I'm trash. But Jesus Christ. This dude, his name is Gelato Ho.
Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top.
Don't give me the ball. Don't give me the ball.
Return sets him up pretty good here, right at the 30-yard line.
Let's just do some suggestions for the first few plays, see what he's running. If his butt's land.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
Ooh, sit down.
Too, but he's a good pass catcher. That's been on display here, Charles, on this opening drive.
And we certainly have seen the benefits of what he did in the offseason, with to spend more time with wide receivers, working on routes, working on cuts,
sit down,
in order to make himself a more complete running back and even more of a threat downfield.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading the action and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Throwing is Jackson. Eluding the pressure running. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble. And now it's third down. The new one pick up for his defense is trying to connect with Lamar Jackson.
Sit down.
Job there on his opening drive of making him uncomfortable.
And you're talking about doing it so early in the game because
that's my fault. It's bad coverage on me.
Have taken the early lead on the road here in Buffalo.
Oh, come the fuck on. Come on. I'm about to get skunked again. God damn.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25.
I did not mean to spin. My finger slipped.
Too short to punt, that in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. They run. It's Williams. And he's getting the first before he's brought down the 39-yard line. The huge is amazing. Much more than that, but by the width of his shoelace, they convert on fourth down. On play action. Ben.
How did he jump in front of me? This shit is fucking whack. Whack.
They've scored on their first two drives. They still haven't given anything up on the other side of the ball, so they can already make this chance a three-score game here if they can come away with points on this drive.
Yeah, they're almost pushing them to the brink. Aren't they, Parker? Almost to the point now. What's a lot of words for me, which I never had signed off on yours, but you just never supposed to see that type of development so quickly in a game like this. Everything they've done has been working so far. It's defense, you need me. It's going to work for them.
And down to the 36-yard line here. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three. To play first half, it's 14 to nothing. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. The front getting with Foreman.
Apparently, Cuffy, I'm popular as fuck in Russia. I don't know. They must have threw some bots on me or something. I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to complain, but geez, Christ, I can't see shit. Act like I can fucking read that. I can't read that. Nyet. Sto. Nutra. Nyet. Okay, that's the extent of my Russian. I fucking fair caught it, and it didn't. If I can somehow score, get the ball at the half, and score again.
Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception, given up the score. You're down double digits. They got to figure out something pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it, and when we look at that sideline,
yeah, they spitting that yin yang, son. Them yin yang and them thing. Yin yang and them thing. Dude, why does he keep fucking fumbling?
Tackles made at the Cowboys 43. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. Vic operating on first down. Over the middle complete. It's Harrison.
I don't know. How do you say Google Translate? I don't know. Look that up for me, Cuffy. I'm glad that wasn't going to get anything anyways. So.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them at the end zone as the first half winds down.
Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. It'll be Vic once more. Under pressure and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard.
Oops, I didn't mean to call timeout.
The Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26.
6 seconds to go until halftime. I'm not even going for a field goal, bro. Field goals ain't gonna do shit for me. Now they're out there again to try once more.
They throw the deep ball, but it winds up to be incomplete. The Bills drive stalls out on fourth down, and the Cowboys defense is gonna get them the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with a 21-0 lead already, man, no need really to take any unnecessary risks.
That one deep for London. And that pass is intercepted. My goodness. That one's loose at the 40. And he gets it back to the first and scores it to the first half.
So I got a score, stop, score, stop, score. Yeah, this thing don't fucking work.
Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here.
Although I was down by 21 yesterday and got down to 7, got the onside kick. So I had a chance.
On EA Sports. The return is Cooper from his end zone. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. Ready to go for their next drive. We'll see, Charles, if they had a chance to hit the reset button at halftime. They have not scored. They're facing this big deficit. And if they're going to come back, it's going to have to start right now.
Yeah, for them, it's not dwelling in the negative because, yeah, they were totally ineffective in the first half. But we've seen many games that have flipped around in the second half. It all starts with this drive right here. They get something good going, put some points on the board, they begin to have hope.
What easy dance? What the fuck is easy dance?
Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount.
Come on.
Certainly hoping to see things get a little bit better for them in this half, weren't we? But it was a downright miserable first half that's carried over with an interception to begin the second half. That's a defeated offense right there. There's still a lot of game left. I don't think that's the last turnover we're going to see today, partner.
From the 46-yard line, a second down and 6. Now it's Jackson. That completes a Drake London.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blows.
Ooh, that was a good audible for me. That was a good audible for me.
And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry. On second down, Jackson. Airing it out deep for Smith.
Ooh, I needed that. Nah, we're not dancing. We're not doing none of that shit. We're fucking losing by 3 scores.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do or die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
Play action now, Vic. And it's taken in by
That was a good hit. That was a touchdown. Okay, I'll take that. It took too long, but at least he didn't fumble that time. Oh, are they?
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Translation. I don't know. I feel like it's just some random chat box. I mean, I don't know why, but I mean, I'll take it. Whatever helps me get to partner or whatever faster. Sit down. Does nobody know how to fucking play defense? Sit down. What the fuck was he doing? He had it. He fucked it up.
position. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now here's Vic. He gets a complete to Harris. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to a guy playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Line of scrimmage, the 24. This is second and 6. Here's Michael Vick.
You fucking whore.
This was touchdown or bust, and unfortunately for them, it turned out to be bust.
Yeah, they're feeling like they've got to face the issue here. Maybe take some chances they wouldn't have earlier in the game. But give credit to this defense. They've really stood tall throughout, and they come up with the interception in the end zone.
Credit it with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Anyone out of bounds, too. Good job, guy.
Mistake.
Yeah, sure. Without a doubt. Because at some point, put your foot in the ground, get upfield, and get down, protecting the ball. Don't go out of bounds. Because when you go out of bounds, you're really just helping the defense.
Yeah, not to be too hyperbolic, but it's like giving the D an extra timeout, isn't it?
It certainly is. Gives them a chance to regroup, and means you have to snap the ball an additional time.
Oh, come on, you're supposed to pick that. Come on.
Slam that window shut.
Well, now comes the Cowboys punter. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. So the punt rolls out of bounds and out of pretty good field position here up near the 40-yard line. Here's first and 10.
GG's. Shut. Stop. See if I can redeem myself. These last two games, I've been real mad.
Into the air right away is Allen. Flushed out right. It's slow there, and it's going to wind up incomplete. I put a check mark in the box where the defense coordinator was saying, how well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Frees up your guys elsewhere.
Yeah, the Manflu was terrible. It's definitely not my idea of fun, especially when my Manflu was actually COVID. But what you got going on, Darkwing Drake? Yes. Needed that.
Thank you very much.
Got him. We gonna flex on these hoes right quick. Sit down. Siéntate. Siéntate.
Lady, go!
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Charles, we know that this offense is aggressive. We saw that last drive. They went for it on fourth down.
Damn, how are you going to have a fucking run defense and be that bad? Oops, sit down. Thank you. Ooh.
Decisive when he took off and ran.
Very decisive and picked up that first down in the process. Escaping the pressure right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
And he's missed now his first four passing attempts. The rhythm is just not there to begin this ball game.
Now it's second and 10. Allen now looks to throw. Eluding the pressure right.
Damn, how the fuck do you have Josh Allen and you're 0 for 5? Dude, I'm not that good.
When that ball left his hand, he broke that line of scrimmage and then let it fly, and that's an automatic flag.
Yeah, you know, you don't just lose the five.
Don't go for it. Punt it. Be smart.
So he obviously needs that better awareness about what he's going to do. Either tuck it and go.
I appreciate that, Bubba.
And get that pass away.
Hey, man, any love I get on here, it's happy for me. I wasn't letting him pass me that time, man. That shit wasn't happening. All right, let's see if his defense is any better than his offense. I'm not going to count that one play. I mean, I got lucky. I ran that motherfucker. Hey Drake, how was your Thanksgiving, buddy?
That's exactly what we've seen so far. They had a touchdown on their opening drive. And now they connect here for another nice gain for a first down. This offense is moving the ball well, exactly as they drew it up in practice.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10, fighting through at the 25.
You quitting? You quitting already? Damn. I guess he saw me juke the fuck out of him and was like, nah, I'm good. He was like, nah, I'm good.
Thank you very much.
Let's see how bad I lose this one.
I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And we go.
I'm going to run this back. I typically don't like to run all that to get to where I'm supposed to go. Yeah, I shouldn't even throw on that. All right, let's run the old tried and true. And I just ran completely backwards. I'm obviously going to punt the ball on 4th and fucking 29. Hello? Oh, Lord. Economic impact assistance. I'm good. Sit down. Siéntate, por favor. Siéntate. Got him. User. How the fuck did I get yards on that? How?
Consecutive positive run snaps. He certainly appears to be trying to put the offense on his back and just move them down the field, but his number is called. The way he's running it, I keep going back to him.
Look at the big man. To the 16-yard line. His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, so to speak.
They run the option here on first and 10. Touchdown. Michael Vick, 16-yard touchdown run. And the Bills are on the board first here on the road in Kansas City. So they're down in the red zone. They opt to utilize his legs instead of the arm. It works out pretty well.
I like what they're thinking there, because in most situations now, defense is accounting for all the other runners on the field and, of course, for pass plays. But the quarterback position.
I've got 105 viewers on Twitch. I have zero viewers on YouTube because, you know, apparently I'm the fucking man on YouTube. Sit down. Siéntate. Siéntate.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way.
Sit down.
The Chiefs in possession as they've got it facing a second and long situation.
No shit, Sherlock. It was obviously the wrong fucking read. Don't quit already. Please don't quit already. God damn it. Why is it every time I'm playing well, they fucking quit right away? Every single time. Like, I'm not even a good Madden player. Oh, Jesus, his team is way better than mine. Holy fuck. Oh, boy. I'm going to lose this one. I'm going to lose this one bad. I will take that. I will take that gladly.
Well, if they didn't get the wake up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms, because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the pay. That was the big one that landed.
Siéntate, por favor. Yeah, fuck you, Carmichael. Complain about a flag all you want. He tried to cover me, and I still scored. You don't want none.
Thank you very much.
That was a good job. That was a good play.
We're used to seeing big plays from him in the passing game. That obviously goes a rushing touchdown. And what a rushing touchdown it was. From start to finish, from the blocking to the running, just well executed.
And now let's look ahead, because after that, how about a little play action, maybe a little bootleg, and get the quarterback out on the corner and give him a little run pass option.
They're right down here looking for six. This is
I'll take that. Give me.
Thank you very much.
Trust me, I'm not this good. His defense just is that bad.
They're leading right now. Absolute dominance throughout this ball game, and no signs of slowing down.
Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is now 21-14. Here's the Bills kickoff unit as they will send this one away. Going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. It's going to be pretty tough for them to match their efficiency, Charles, in that last possession, needing only the one play to find the end zone on the rushing touchdown.
Yeah, they got that together collectively, didn't they? Total group effort. Although the guy toting the rock, he gets all the credit. It was blocked up so well. The only thing stopping him was running into the goalpost in the back of the end zone.
What clock depth is here? And this is not the way they started, right? Now
bullshit. That wasn't good. Fucking had him.
Teams in this first half, it's been fun, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today, it's track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far. Fun to watch.
Don't quit. Don't quit. Come on. You're only down 7. finally get to play somebody whose team is worse than mine. This doesn't really happen very often, so I'm gonna don't fuck it up. Just don't fuck it up. I'm probably gonna fuck it up. Flex on these hoes.
And the Bills will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon.
As a general rule, quarterbacks don't want to lock in on a receiver before the ball is snapped. But in this case, based on the matchup he thought he was going to get, it was favorable for his tight end. He locked in on
okay.
the early.
All right, let's see what the dude's got for offense.
Special teams as he'll get him.
Well, apparently his offense wasn't bad, but I consider that just a bad play call, honestly.
Thank you very much.
Thank
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Come on. That's Marvin fucking Harrison. He's not going to drop that. Never in his life is he going to drop that. That worked out great. I didn't want that play. I want something else. Oh, Jesus Christ, that's on me. That was good coverage. That was very good coverage.
Thank you.
game.
Always up for the goal.
Come on.
Christian McCaffrey. Fielded at about the 28. That'll wind up being a 50-yard punt, though they do get 10 back on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. And then you get two scores here in the row. That's a heck of a start. And not only have they fought the battle, I wonder if they visualized. I remember playing and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did something with that. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 37-yard line. Back to throw. Vic.
What's the fucking point having somebody in deep zone if they're not gonna fucking do their job? Yeah, this guy's really fucking good. This guy's
touchdown. And the Cowboys have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Another impressive drive. So they're 2 for 2, 2 touchdowns. Charles, a great start to this ball game for them. And one of the words that's really worked its way into our lexicon is stack it. They've stacked momentum each time now. Team.
One more.
I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has, and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Sucks on these hoes.
Thank you very much.
Got him. Got him. Oh, he's gonna quit. What a bitch. Face down.